Yeah, good morning. Today I'm going to explain about the time domain specifications of a control systems. Here, if you have this figure, we are having a different time response of the control system with respect to time. Here, the main time domain specifications are delay time, rise time, peak time, settling time, and peak overshoot. So, first we need to know the meaning of delay time. It is the time taken for the response to reach 50% of the final value for the very first time, so that TD is equal to, we are giving as 1 plus 0.7 zeta by omega n. Similarly, rise time is equal to, we are showing with TR symbol. It is the time taken for the response to rise from 0 to 100 for the very first time. TR is equal to, we are having equation as 5 minus theta by omega d, where theta is equal to, we are taking it as tan inverse of root of 1 minus theta square by zeta, where the meaning of zeta is damping factor or damping ratio. We are knowing the damped frequency of oscillations would be given as omega d is equal to omega n into root of 1 minus zeta square. Similarly, peak time, the meaning for peak time is, it is the time taken for the response to reach the peak value for the very first time. Tp is equal to pi by omega n into root of 1 minus theta square, also is equal to, you can write as pi by omega d. As you know, all of you, omega d is equal to omega n into root of 1 minus theta square. Next one is peak overshoot. So peak overshoot is the meaning for, it is defined as simply the ratio of maximum peak value measured from final value to initial value. From final value to final value. Here, MP is equal to, you can define it as C of TP minus C of infinity by C of infinity. Also is equal to exponential of minus zeta pi by under root 1 minus zeta square. Last one is settling time. It is defined as the time taken by the response to reach and stay within a specified error. Here, the specified error is taken as percentage of final value. So we can write TS as 4 by zeta omega n, where 1 by n, 1 by zeta omega n is equal to, we are taking it as T. This is equal to finally 4 into capital T. It is for the error of 2 of a settling time. Again, we are having, if you take 5% of error, then TS will be equal to 3T. So TS is equal to, we are calculating for the two different values of error. One is 2% error of settling time and 5% of error of settling time. Finally, damping ratio, zeta. Here, the meaning for damping ratio is the ratio of the actual damping to the critical damping. Now, we will discuss about the second order system. Here, the standard form of closed-loop transfer function of a second order system is expressed by C of s is equal to C of s by R of s is equal to omega n square by s square plus 2 zeta omega n s plus omega n square, where omega n is the meaning for undamped natural frequency, zeta is the meaning for damping ratio. Here, depending upon the value of zeta, the system can be classified into following groups: undamped system where zeta is equal to 0, underdamped system where zeta is less between 0 to 1, critically damped where the zeta is equal to 1, overdamped where the zeta value is greater than 1. So as you know, the characteristic equation of the second system will be given as s square plus 2 zeta omega ns plus omega n square is equal to 0. It is also a quadratic equation, and the roots of that one are s1 s2 is equal to minus 2 zeta omega n plus or minus under root 4 zeta square omega n square minus 4 omega square n whole by 2. So this also equal to minus 2 zeta omega n plus or minus under root 4 omega n square of zeta square minus 1 whole by 2. Here minus zeta omega n plus or minus omega n into root of zeta square minus 1. So this is the root of this quadratic equation. Now we will see the different responses of the system for the second order system when inputs are unit step, unit ramp, unit parabolic, etc., etc. Now we will see for the undamped system when the input is unit step. Here the standard form of the closed loop transfer function of a second order system is C of S by R of S is equal to, we are taking it as omega n square by S square plus 2 zeta omega n S plus omega n square. For undamped system, we are all know zeta will be equal to, undamped system means we have to take zeta as 0. From that, this value will become as omega n square by S square plus omega n square. Here, we are keeping R of S as 1 by S because we are taking input as unit step. From that, C of S will be taken as R of S into omega n square by S square plus omega n square. We can also write it as 1 by R of S is equal to 1 by S here. So this will become as 1 by S into omega n square by S square plus omega n square. We need to simplify this equation again. For that we need to use partial fraction method. By application of the partial fraction method, C of S is equal to omega n square by S into S square plus omega n square, that is also equal to A by S, we are writing B by S square plus omega n square. Here A can be taken as, by putting S is equal to 0 in this equation, we will get A value as S into C of S. Here S is equal to, we are taking omega n square by S into S square, S into S square plus omega n square, where you need to cancel the both S's in the numerator and under denominator. Now this will become as omega n square by S square plus omega n square. Now we need to keep S equal to 0 here. From that, omega n square by omega n square is equal to 1. So we are having A value as 1 here. Similarly, by multiplying C of S by S square plus omega n square for getting B value, at the same time you need to apply S square as minus omega n square, or you can take S is equal to J omega n. From that, we should apply in our response C of S is multiplied with S square plus omega n square, then omega n square by S into S square plus omega n square is multiplied by S square plus omega n square. Now these two will be cancelled. Now we are getting only omega n square by S, where S equal to, we are taking it as J omega n. In numerator we are having omega n square, and in the numerator in the denominator we are having J omega n. Now 1 omega n will be cancelled here, but we are having omega n by J. It is called minus J omega n, that is equal to minus S. From that we are having so far A equal to plus 1, B is equal to minus S. Now we have to apply in our partial fraction. Now A will be taken as 1, B will be taken as minus S, though the final output will be 1 by S minus S by S square plus omega n square. Now the time domain response C of T will be equal to inverse Laplace of C of S, that is equal to inverse Laplace of 1 by S minus S by S square plus omega n square. This also is equal to inverse of 1 by S is equal to 1, S by S square plus omega n means we are taking it as cos omega n t. Now the response of the undamped second order system for unit step input is taken as 1 minus cos omega n t, that will be drawn graphically like this. So the response of undamped system is completely oscillating model. Okay, nah? All of you. Now we have to go for response of second order system for a critical damped system when the input is same input step. Here we are having zeta equal to 1. From that we need to get C of S by R of S as omega n square by S square plus 2 zeta omega n S plus omega n square. From that we are, by application of the zeta is as 1, we are having omega n square by S plus omega n square n whole square. When R of T is equal to 1, R of S equal to 1 by S. From that we can have C of S is equal to 1 by S into omega n square by S square S plus omega n whole square. This will become as omega n square by S into S plus omega n square. By taking partial fraction, this will be taken as A by S, B by S plus omega n square, C by S plus omega n. By having some considerations for getting S equal to 0, for A, for S equal to minus omega n, for B, for C equal to, you are taking S equal to minus omega n, we are having A is equal to 1, B is equal to omega n minus omega n, c equal to minus 1. From that, we are having the response in time domain as inverse Laplace of c of s. So here we are having c of s as like that, 1 by s minus omega n whole by s plus omega n whole square minus 1 by s plus omega n. By taking inverse Laplace transformation of that equation, we are having c of t as 1 minus omega n into t exponential of minus omega n t minus exponential of minus omega n t. Also, we are taking it as 1 minus exponential of minus omega n t is taking common for the both 1 and omega n t. So, after having this equation, we will draw the graphically like this. Here, the response of critical damped second order system will be having no oscillations. Okay, clear all of you? Thank you.